गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट. सो टुडे विल स्टार्ट द पार्ट 3 ऑफ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सेकेंड पीयू कोर्स, दैट इज इलेक्ट्रिक चार्जेस एंड फील्ड्स. सो हियर यू कैन सी द थंडरिंग एंड द लाइटनिंग इफेक्ट ऑफ द क्लाउड्स. ओके, दैट इज ड्यू टू द स्टैटिक चार्जेस. दैट्स व्हाई आई हैव रिटन हियर, आई हैव टेकन द पिक्चर ऑफ द लाइटनिंग. So now let us go to the basic properties of electric charge. So we are coming to the properties. We are discussing here about the basic properties of the electric charges. So let us see what are the basic properties of the charges. Additivity of the electric charges. So what is meant by this additivity of the charges? Additivity is nothing but the adding of the charges. Right, how we have to add the charges in a body. Okay, so electric charge is additive, that is total charge on an extended body is total charge on an extended body is the algebraic sum of the charges on different regions of the body. So if this is a body, any irregular size it may be, shape. So let us call here there is a charge Q1, Q2 on the surface, not inside. Okay, because this we are talking about the static electricity, right? So here on the surface there are charges Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4. So what will be the net charge on this body, that we are going to see. So here whether it is positive or negative, we have to add all those charges, then we will get the net charge on that body. Therefore, if we take Q as the net charge of this body, then it is given by Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. That means adding the individual charges, we'll get the net charge on this body. So if this is a body and suppose here Q1 is positive, Q2 is negative, Q3 is positive again, okay, on the surface of this body, then we will write Q1 is equal to, Q1 is positive, so we will take plus here, but Q2 is minus, plus of minus Q2 plus Q3. So therefore the net charge is Q1 minus Q2 plus Q3. So this gives a net charge on the body. Okay, so first property is the additive property of the electric charge, and it depends on the sign of the charge, whether it is positive or negative, we have to consider the sign of the individual charges. Okay, so positive and negative charges are added like real numbers, that is total charge on a body is the sum of all the individual charges. While adding the charges, we should take their sign. Okay, so this is the additivity of the electric charge. Okay, so now let us go to the second property. So conservation of electric charge. So what is meant by conservation of charge? So conservation is nothing but after what the purpose is done, it should remain constant. So whatever we are doing the work on those charges, it should be equal before LHS, after in the LHS and in the RHS, they should be equal, right? So that is the conservation of the charge, right? So now let us see, according to the law of conservation of electric charge, the net electric charge, that is algebraic sum of the positive and negative charges in an isolated system, remains constant. So now here in this example you can see a silk cloth is rubbed to the glass rod. So now there is exchange of the charges, right? The glass rod gains the positive charges and the silk cloth gains the negative charges. How many charges the glass rod is losing to the silk cloth? They are equal. Okay, so here charges can neither be created nor destroyed. That means charge will not be created or else it will be destroyed, but it will be transferred from one body to another body. Okay, now the glass rod is giving the charges to the silk cloth, right? It is giving, the charges are transferring from the glass rod to the silk cloth. Okay, so hence the number of positive charges it is gaining in the glass rod, that many charges will be gone to or transferred to the silk cloth. Okay, therefore for example, I have taken here a glass rod rubbed with piece of silk cloth gets positively charged, whereas silk cloth becomes negatively charged. Okay, so glass rod, how much it is giving to the silk cloth, that many positive charges are on the reside on the glass rod, that many charges also reside on the silk cloth which are negative, because it is gaining. So that the substance or the atom which gains the charges will be negatively charged, and the substance which loses the charge will be positively charged. Hope you have understood this conservation of electric charge. So how many charges a substance is losing will be equal to the number of charges gained by the substance. Therefore, positive charge on the glass rod is equal to negative charge on the silk cloth. So this is known as the conservation of the charges. Hence, there is constant. So according to the law of conservation of electric charge, the net electric charge in an isolated system remains constant. Okay, so it remains constant. Hence, this meaning of this is nothing but charges can neither be created nor destroyed. Come, okay? But it will be transferred from one form to another form, or it will be transferred from one body to another body. Hope you have understood this conservation of electric charge. Now let us switch on to another example here. So I have taken here an example of alpha decay in an uranium 92. Okay, it decays by emitting a alpha particle. Alpha particle is nothing but the helium nucleus. So what it gives is the thorium atom. So here uranium 238 and 92 gives thorium 234. So here helium has 4 atoms, so 2, and here LHS is equal to RHS. So number of elementary charges before the decay, the electrons, how many it is? Here it is 92, here it is 90 plus here 2. So the equation is balanced here, right? Number of elementary charges before the decay is 92, number of elementary charges after decay is 90 plus 2. Hence the electric charge is conserved. So I have given two examples here for conservation of the electric charge. One is about the rod, glass rod and the silk cloth. Okay. And here another example is the uranium, which decays by emitting alpha particle to form the thorium atom. Right. So therefore, now let us go to the last one, third property, that is the quantization of the charge. So quantization is existence of charges in discrete. Quanta is nothing but a packet of energy. Quanta is nothing but quanta packet of energy it is. Okay, now quantization of energy is discrete packets of this charge is in the form of continuous distribution of the charges. So there is continuous flow of the charge, right? So how, what is the magnitude of the charge, value of the charge? It is 1.602192 × 10⁻¹⁹. So again approximately we will take it as C E equal to 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb, right? So this is the magnitude of the charge or the value of the charge, right? Thus quantization is a property of an electric charge by virtue of which any charged particle can have charge which is an integral multiple of the basic or elementary charge E. So that is Q equal to plus or minus N into E. Plus or minus Y we will take because it may be positive charge or negative charge. So therefore N into E, N times. So N is nothing but how many charges are there. So net charge on that body is given by Q is equal to plus or minus N into E. Okay, then that is Q is the total charge on the body. N may be any real number 1, 2, 3 dash dash. Okay, now E is the magnitude of the charge. That is 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹. Therefore Q equal to 0 plus or minus E plus or minus 2 E and here. So it should be N equal to 0, 1, 2. Okay. So N is equal to 0, 1, 2. Okay. So this is the quantization of the charge. And this equation is the quantization of the charge. It is the packet of energy in the discrete form. So the charges are moving in the discrete form of packet of energy, hence like photons. So photons are the discrete packet of energy. Here also charges, how many it is losing, it will be like it is a packet of energy. That is given by plus or minus N into E, where E is the magnitude of the charge, 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb. Okay, now we will solve one numerical. A polythene piece is rubbed with wool and it has been found to acquire a negative charge of 3 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb. So sub question 1 is, how many electrons have transferred from wool to polythene piece? Sub question 2 is there a transfer of mass from wool to polythene? If yes, how much? So now we will solve the problem. So I will change the color of the pen. So here, let us take Q is equal to, so it is negative charge. Q is given as solution, I will write here, minus 3, okay, no bracket, minus 3 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb. Okay, and E is what? So it is a negative charge, so we will take it as 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb. Okay, so now using the quantization equation, Q equal to quantization of the charges, Q is equal to N into, I hope you recollect it. So N is number of the electrons transferred, so that we don't know. So N is unknown here, Q we know and E we know. So N is equal to Q upon E, that is equal to Q is minus 3 × 10⁻¹⁹ divided by E is how much, as it is a electron or the charges, negative charges. So we'll take minus of 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹. So this is 7 here. So when we calculate this, minus minus gets cancelled and what we get is 1.875 into 10 raised to 12. So this minus 19 becomes plus 19. So plus 19 minus 7 is 12. Plus 12 we get. So n is equal to how much? It is 1.87 into 10 raised to 12. So big number we have got. The number of charges is how many? When the polythene is rubbed with the wool, so these many charges are transferred from wool piece to polythene piece. Okay, so let us see the second sub-question. What is the second question? Is there a transfer of mass from wool to polythene? If yes, how much? So now we will write mass transferred is equal to n into mass of electron. So n we got 1.875 into 10 raised to 12, and charge of the mass of the electron is 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 kg. Okay, so answer is, so how much mass is transferred is 1.706 into 10 raised to minus 18 kg. Yes, mass is transferred from wool to polythene. Okay, so this is the solution of this numerical. So how much mass is transferred? 1.706 into 10 raised to minus 18 kg of mass. So how much electrons are moved, transferred from the wool to polythene pieces? 1.875 into 10 raised to 12. Okay. Thank you for watching.